Hello everyone, I am Dr. Priya Sapaha. Today we are going to discuss simple hurt in the Indian Penal Code. In my previous video, we have discussed assault. Now usually people get confused and think that assault, hurt and grievous hurt are one and the same thing, but they are different in nature. Assault is something where a criminal force has been used to make an injury, to give a bodily injury to another person with either by himself or by the use of any substance or by the use of any animal. That comes under assault. Whereas in hurt, there is also a bodily injury is given, but it is not at all necessary that a criminal force is always used. There may be simple hurt accidentally also, but there must be intention of causing simple hurt. There may be use of criminal force also. So here it is, it may be used, it must not. For example, if I know that someone is coming to my room and I have deliberately put some obstacle in behind the door so that the person will come and he will get hurt. So that also is intentional hurt given to some other person. It may be a simple hurt. So that comes under the category of hurt. Similarly, it is said that emotional and mental hurt doesn't come under the category of simple hurt under IPC. But if any emotional or mental hurt, which is for the consequence of that particular hurt, if there is a physical injury, then it will come under the category of hurt. How? If I know that my uncle is a heart patient and I have to give a news to my uncle that his son is no more, and with an intention to cause an injury, a bodily injury to my uncle, I deliberately go to my uncle and give that news in such a way that your son is dead, so that my uncle is having a heart attack. Now here, with an intention to cause a bodily injury and to give a hurt, I have given such an emotional and mental trauma to my uncle that it has resulted into a bodily harm or a bodily hurt, that is heart attack. So that also comes under the category of hurt. So in that case, it is necessary to understand that to cause hurt, it is necessary that there must be guilty intention. Guilty intention means that there must be mens rea. The motive must be to cause and hurt. The intention must be to cause hurt. And the person who is causing hurt is having that knowledge that if I will do so, definitely that person will get injured. So if all these things will be covered in any act, that comes under the category of hurt. Section 319 defines simple hurt, which says that if any person is a reason behind any bodily pain or disorder or disease to cause to another person, if he may be man or woman, then it will be amount as simple hurt. That means there are three categories. The first one says that there must be bodily pain which is given by some another person. Here there may be use of criminal force. Now the second one says that there must be some disorder which is caused by due to the words or due to anything, any act which is done by any other person. Now that act may be anything which is resulted into which type of disorder? It may be a depression, it may be restlessness, it may be hysteria, it may be heart attack, it may be palpitation. That means that there must be some disorder which has been caused by the words or act by some another person. That if I am not emotionally strong and I cannot take any bad news which has been given to me in a very blunt manner, and if someone is giving any bad news in a very blunt manner, that means that he is causing hurt to me. That amounts under hurt under section 319. Similarly, the third category is disease. Now we are having a good example of COVID-19. that if deliberately, if someone is transmitting any disease to anyone else, that do amount under the category of simple hurt. That means if I know that I am having certain disease and deliberately I am transmitting that disease to anyone else, that means it comes under the category of simple hurt. So basically in simple hurt, there are three categories: that any sort of bodily pain, disorder or disease has been given by some other person to another person, that amounts under simple hurt. So this is all about simple hurt under IPC. I hope you like the video, and if you like it, do not forget to hit the like button and subscribe my channel. You may also follow me in various social media platforms, that is FB page Law Colloquium, Instagram Law Colloquium, LinkedIn Law Colloquium, YouTube and Twitter with the name of Dr. Priya Sipaha, and I have my website also, that is priyasipaha.com, where I share different notes, contemporary news, articles, blogs, etc. You may also submit blog in my website to get published. You can have a detail on my website, that is priyasipaha.com. So do share your blog and do give your feedbacks in the comment box. Thank you for watching. See you soon. Bye bye.